Hi, this is Marcus. I want to do a video to show you some of the differences between Aperture and Lightroom and why I would recommend using plugins to streamline your post-production work. One of the things in Lightroom is that Lightroom and Aperture is that these programs both work with JPEGs, but they're designed for RAW files if you're shooting RAW. And what it allows you to do is it allows you to make non-destructive edits to the photo and allows you to do things very quickly that within Photoshop it would take you much longer to do. And these programs have matured over the years that they've been out to where you can actually, in my opinion, do about 80 to 90% of your work in Lightroom or Aperture without ever having to open up Photoshop unless you have to do some serious restoration work. Now, one thing I've done is on this photo here, a lot of times I'll require my subjects not to wear any makeup, and I'll correct the blemishes and stuff as I go. Now, let me just show you just this one thing in Lightroom. Lightroom, they both have these healing tools that you can try to take away blemishes. So just say, for instance, I've clicked on the healing tool here, right? And here is the healing tool, and I want to remove, say if I want to remove this right here. Or in Lightroom, this is very kludgy because you have to move and drag, and then sometimes it might line up correctly and then it might not. Let me just zoom into this. You can see that there's a problem with how that skin is actually lining up. So if I go here again, I have to try to find, it's basically hit and miss. You know, you might find something to match up with it, then you might not, okay? And then if I go back and just take this off and remove those, you can see the areas where that's not done correctly. And this is in Lightroom. This is just one of the flaws that's inside of Lightroom. You're using the spot healing tool. I'm going to remove this and clear it out. Now, if I go into Aperture, Aperture did a much better job with their tool with this because I'm going to zoom in right quick. We're just going to start zooming in a whole lot quicker so I can get to the face. All right. And I'll show you. Now, in Aperture, I can just go here and say I want to do a retouch. And in the retouch, I can do repair. And I'll go ahead and increase my brush for the repair. And it's just very quickly. And just start replacing things. And then I work about trying to drag it from one pixel to the other. It just does a much better job right out of the box. That's one thing that you don't get in Lightroom. If I want to do skin repair, I can do that right here by doing skin smoothing. And then again, I go ahead and increase my brush. And if I just start brushing over it, you'll see that it's smoothing out the skin. And I can do these different things, and it'll take me a little time to do this, you know, because each photo is different. You know, you can actually go and do that. And if I go back in Lightroom, you can pretty much do the same thing. This has got my, you know, skin healing, but I can go into the brush. And in the brush, I can go ahead and set my brush and start doing some type of skin smoothing. They have some corrective stuff down here that you can actually use. But what I would suggest for all of these products is the easiest way to get this done and the fastest way, especially when you're dealing with larger photos. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to use a plugin, and I'm going to use a Perfect Suite plugin. So we're going to go under here, and I'm going to go under Edge Plugins, and I'm going to tell it to do it in Layers. Now the reason I'm going to open this up in Layers is because it is going to give me access to all of the other applications where I can just continually be able to just keep working. What I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna stay in this application until I'm finished with it. So you can see right now, it actually brought it in. It's gonna use Layers to let me do what I need to do with this. So for the first thing that I wanna do with this is I wanna use the portrait because I wanna correct some of the problems as far as smoothing the skin and those kind of things. So I'm gonna hit portrait. And what it's gonna do is create me a layer, and it's gonna go ahead and detect the face real quickly. And then when it detects the face, it's going to go ahead and start making what it sees as adjustments that it can make. But I'm going to go in and fine detail them and do it a whole lot quicker. So you can see it went and made some corrections, and it detected the face. But I'm going to go ahead and correct this a little bit better. So we're going to go here. And when we go into this, you can see how it selected the eyes. It didn't select them correctly. So I'm going to go ahead and fine tune it. So the eyes are going to be corrected. Much better. Okay. It assumed where it thought the eyes was, but again, it didn't mask them correctly. So I'm going to go in here. Okay. and the lips. And while I'm doing this, whenever you go out and you get headshots taken or you get wedding photos taken or any kind of photos taken by a professional photographer, when you go out to a professional photographer, you're paying for the photographer to do these type of things for you. You want your photos to be better than just someone pointing the camera and clicking. So at no time should no photographer ever deliver you a picture where you have blemishes and things that's on the picture, because you're paying for a professional to make your photos better than what you could get yourself. And so, and I see that a lot where people just, you know, take the picture and give it to them. And it's just one of my quirks. I don't think that's, you know, a thing anyone should be doing. But anyway, so we're going to go back to this. Now it's made the adjustments a little bit better. Okay. I'm going to zoom into the face a little bit closer so we can see the things. Okay. And so I can actually see the changes made. And the first thing I'm going to do is the blemishes are just too high. I'm going to reduce them because I'm going to take some of them off. What you want to do is keep some of the texture of the skin. You don't want to make it too smooth where it's like porcelain. And people have a tendency, they'll go up under the eyes and they'll remove every wrinkle. Well, that's unrealistic. So you don't want to do that. You want to leave the natural beauty stuff in place. If it's not anything that's taken away from the photo, you don't have to correct it just because you can correct it. And I'm going to add some shine to the skin. Okay. Now, it saw her ethnicity, which it assumed it correctly. I can actually do a color shift and change the skin. I'm going to leave it pretty much like what it was. And I think I'm going to probably darken her up just a little taste, give a little bit more color to it. The eyes are perfect. I don't have to whiten up the eyes, but I want to give some more detail to the eyes. So I'm going to go ahead and drag this here so the eyes will be a little bit more sharper. Okay. And there's no teeth or anything that are showing, so I don't have to whiten the smile, but I am going to give some vibrance to her lips. Just to give some vibrance to it, okay? And then on top of that, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take this healing tool and all these blemishes that I got, I'm going to remove them. I'm just going to click and just get rid of them, the ones that I don't want. I do want to keep that mole on the side. That could be like a beauty mark. I want to keep that. I'm going to get rid of this. Get rid of this. And just go through this, you know, and just get rid of any blemishes that I see. And again, you don't want to overdo it. You want the photo to look real. That is the problem I see on Facebook. A lot of people post photos of different things, and a person that's been using Facebook can spot a photo and tell when it's been a Photoshop edit. I mean, I can. I can see all the edits that have been done because there's errors that's made with it. They're either overdone or the textures have been deleted and a whole bunch of other things. So go right here. I'm going to reduce this brush and go right here to the nose part. Clear that up right there. Get this part here. Okay, and there's a little redness in there. We'll go ahead and clear that up. Okay. So far, that's nice. So if I go back out to fit the screen, that came out to be okay. Now, I can also use this tool to fix any blemishes that's on the skin. So I'm going to go ahead and make this brush big because I want to go ahead and really get these done quickly. And so I don't have to just be restricted to the face. Ah, that's a mistake. The brush was too big. Let's go back and reduce the brush. You have to really do it. You know, you don't want to take a big swooping brush and do something because it looks good while it's small. But when you're doing this, and so you can see those right there, right? You can see those errors that it actually did. So now what I have to do is this right here. You can see the errors that are coming in because of the bone thing. And that's a mistake that I made. So we're just going to undo all that and get it out. And I need to go into it. I'm going 50% so I can actually see and drag down. And now I'm able to do better. And then I'll just reduce my brush size and just remove that. That's one of the reasons why you don't want to do a big swooping brush. There's some hair on the skin. I can get that off as well. Remove some of the stuff here. Move it down. This right here was an issue. Let's go back up because I did it at a large level. Okay, put that back. Okay, we're gonna move over to here. And again, I'm just gonna remove these things once he renders it. I'm just gonna remove it there. And a lot of the other stuff as far as the skin smoothing that I can actually do inside of Aperture, not Aperture, but Lightroom. But this is fine. Okay, so I got that in there, and that's fine. So now I'm going to say apply. It applies this effect. It's going to throw me back into layers. And while I'm in layers, I have the ability to go back into another program and do some more stuff with it. So now I'm back in layers. You can see what I did for perfect portrait. That's what it used. And if I turn it off, there go the originals. There go to where I made my adjustments. But I'm not done yet. I want to go into black and white. And I want to convert this to black and white. So by doing this, there are some presets that you can use. I'm not going to use any presets. What I'm going to do is just start turning on things that I want to be on. I'm going to border. And we're going to go ahead and choose a film. Let me see. I want to use a film border. I'll tell you about it. Just get a simple border. The border size is actually too big, so we're going to do that. I don't want it to be round. I want it to be a square border. Okay. We're going to go like that. And then we're going to go into sharpening. And with this sharpening, I can go and use progressive amount of sharpening that I want to do. I want to reduce a lot of the sharpening. I don't want to be too much. I want the skin to be protected. The ethnicity, again, we're going to go back and choose black. That's where she is. I'm just going to go and make some, protect the lights. And of course, you can do some blending. Okay. This should be fine. If I wanted to go ahead and start changing some things by actually brightening it up, I'm going to take this brush. I'm going to hit this, and I want to start brightening up the hair. I don't want that to be as dark. And I've got this box checked to say perfect brush, so I don't want to be perfect in there. I don't want this to be that dark. I want the hair to come out. Okay. And that's what I'm using for that. I'm going to go ahead and do that. This right here can give me some contrast. So again, I can do some contrast with this. Again, I don't have to be perfect with it. Just go ahead and lighten it up. Go ahead and lighten up the hair. You don't want that to be lightened up. Go over here. Okay. And it seems to work okay. I'm going to go back up in here. I can add a vignette. If I turn on the vignette, you can see that comes on. So I'm going to add that on there. I can add some toner if I want to do that as well. I can even add some glow to it. Glow would give us some kind of glow. But I'm going to reduce the amount of glow that I'm giving it. I want it to be that much, and reduce the halo of it. Okay. And go back up here, and I can really play with some stuff again. And again, you can bring the shadows back out. All right, that's too much. Just gonna lower it back down, and bring some shadows out. We want to set some details. That's too much details, making it too sharp. Just a little bit, not that much. About right there. Okay, and so that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and hit apply. And again, what it's going to do is take me back to layers. And I can still go into another program, and I could either mask her out and put her in a different background, or I could use the focus or resize her. So when this gets done, I'm going to go back in and do some effects. And then I'm going to make the round robin back to Lightroom. But this is one of the reasons why you want to use the effects, because doing this, not using plugins, having to do this in Photoshop, you can do it, but it would take much longer and require much more knowledge on your end of how to do it. So again, it took all the stuff that was combined in this and made it into one layer. So again, if I hit this, that's the original. Back that, if I shut that off and turn that back on, that's that. So that got all of my copies. So let's go into effects. And into effects, what I'm going to do is, there's different presets that you can actually use. I'm going to go in with, you know, I can look at this and see if I want to use some HDR. Let's look at a high key set just to go through this. If I roll it over and click this one, that's too much. Didn't want that. I could reduce it, but I don't like how that looks. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down here. I don't need to do a retouch, but I want to make it soft. I want to do a soft focus. So we're going to go with more of a white soft focus here. Where it's softer. It got some glow to it. I can reduce some of the strength. Increase increase some of the halo. Hit apply. Now that's the photo. If I want it, I hit save. This photo is going to save it as a PSD. So I can actually take this photo and take it into Photoshop and maintain all my layers and start doing work on it within Photoshop. So that's a really cool feature that you can use. And once it comes back, it's going to update the photo within Lightroom. And it's going to maintain the original. So it never changes the original. It just gives me another copy of this one here. So once it does that, okay, that's been done. I'm going to go ahead and close this up. I'm going to go to the library. And there we go. And that's the photo there. And again, it did not touch the original. If I open this up, find it, and I expand this out. This is one of three. So here go one, two. So you can see them, but they never touched the original. I go back to this one. That's the original. Go back here again. I can collapse this as well and make it one, but I'm going to go back to this one. And that's my new edits. And you look at the histogram, I put the histogram very good. And now if I want to take it back into Lightroom and do some additional things to it, because it's black and white, I can do some things. I can change the color temperature. I can do some curve stuff with it. I can do some lane correction. Get this out of here. I can do some lens corrections. I go on in here, enable on this, and then choose. And you can see what lens it was shot with, but if I wanted to use a different type of lens, like an 85 millimeter lens, I can do this, and it'll give it a look as an 85 millimeter lens. And so, and if I want to add a vignette, I can do that. Right. And you know, you can do pretty much what you want to do with this. Go back into effects for this right here. Again, if I wanted to add a more of a vignette to it, I can do that. But now you can see it start clipping, as you see right there. It's making a clip. That's the blackness. That's fine. So it doesn't, that's not a problem. Go back to bring it back to what it was before, about right there. And that's good. And so that's the photo. So I just wanted to share that with you. These plugins are an absolute godsend. When you go into these plugins, again, there's six plugins that come with this one. And also there's some now that's owned by Google called Nick Software, which was purchased by Google. But this one gives you the masking tool, the portrait, the effects, black and white, the focus, and the reset. Not reset, the resize. So I could take that photo and make it big enough to go on a poster. So just wanted to share that with you. So thanks for watching.